tickets, please. Who's not paid? Anybody paid twice? You what, love? Do we go over the canal bridge? We're going to get wet through if we don't. Now then, Dobson, how are you getting on with your experiment? Good boy. Keep the Bunsen burner under your pipette. Well, I must say it's a joy to walk into the school laboratory and find you all so industrious. Now, what's young Kenworthy doing? Kenworthy! Who gave you permission to split that atom?
The next half hour, we take the lid off life in Al Reed 64. And here with some random observations on the time, the place, and the people, ladies and gentlemen, it's Al Reed.
Trouble. There's no end to it when you look round. Take clothes. We know clothes make the man, but what about the women? You've never finished. It's every time you go anywhere. Do you get this? You must do. How much longer have I got to keep turning out in this tatty old coat? You're caught with it now. 1957 you bought me this, and I've never liked it. I've shortened it, put tucks in it, turned the collar, turned the cuffs. If I turn anything else, I'll be wearing it inside out. Never mind hiding behind your paper. Look at it. The only time I felt right in it was when I won first prize at that fancy dress ball. And I wouldn't care, but I'd only gone to watch. Well, why don't you wear that two-piece? It's very... I'm not going out in that thing. Makes me look fat. You see, I missed that staff dinner because I'd only that knee-length taffeta that went with the black bottom. I'll bet I'm the only woman in this street with three armholes in a nightie. Then you wonder why I won't come to bed until you've switched the light off. Now, you're making it up, am I? I haven't got one rig out that matches. You see, you took me to that cocktail party and I daren't take me out of because I'd only one earring. I never had to manage like this before we were married, I know that. I've one pair of flat-heel shoes and those were high heels when I bought them. Of course, when you reckon it up, I don't think we men are altogether perfect. I mean, we do need a bit of prodding. Go on, be honest. When did you last buy the wife a new rig out? It's easy enough these days with all these dress shops. Have you had some? Sat outside those cubicles like a ninny while the shop assistant yanks those curtains across? What a scene. Miss Harrington... Bring me that pink organdy we took out of the sale, will you? Well, we'll just get this off. Yes, you're quite right. It is a bit full in the hips. You see, I know you like the colour, but we've nothing your size, you see. You see. You see, we've an 8, a 42, but nothing in between. Let me see. You didn't like any of these with the low neck. This blue one you were undecided about until we found you'd got it on back to front. Then there was this one. Now, I liked you in that. Myself. Oh, I'm sorry, that's the one you came in. This was the one your husband said made you look stout. And yes, yes. Well, would you like your husband to see what he thinks? Price? 49 guineas, madam. Pardon? Would he really? Well, we won't tell him then. No, let me help you off with it, madam. Just hold your arms up and let me get it over your... If you could just... Anne, will you come and help me with this a moment? You see, if we could... See, if you just bend forward and I could pull it over your... No, it's stuck. My word, it is tight. See, Anne, go round that other side. Don't touch the zip at all. You'll nip her! Get Valerie. I think if Madam sat on the floor, we could... Now then, don't push while I'm pulling. Anne, you catch hold of her on the skirt and I'll just eat it over her. Don't worry about your hair, madam. Valerie, dear, just hold this sleeve, will you? Pull gently. We'll soon have it. Mind her head in that mirror. It's not ours. Miss Harrington, could you bring madam a cup of tea? Oh, and send out for some of those slimming biscuits. We'll just have to... Yes, the slimming biscuits. We'll just have to hang on here until she loses weight. Hello? Is that Arizona 57891? is that Mr. Goldwater? Well, is he in? In the bath? Oh, is he? Oh, well, I'll wait till he dries off then. Tony, I'm phoning from a call box and it's £3 a minute. It's in our paper where it says we're a second class nation. Yeah, well, I've got something to tell him. No, it wouldn't be the same if you told him. No, well, it isn't a message exactly. Does he know me? No, not yet, but he will do. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Hello? Is that Mr. Goldwater? No, I want Mr. Goldwater. I've got something to tell him. It won't take a minute if he could just slip his trousers on. I'd be very grateful if you would. Yes, I'll hang on. Mr. Goldwater? Oh, but have you spoken to him? He said what? Well, that's funny. That's what I was going to tell him.
It was just striking tea time last Tuesday but two when a chap from next door gave a knock. He said, quick. I said, where? He said, here. I said, who? He said, you. I said, Christ, that's a shock. Upstairs on his landing where both of us flew was his wardrobe jammed tight in the door. Well, we pushed it and shoved it, but all we could do was to wedge the thing more than before. Well, we hammered the door off and hacked out the drawers, but it wouldn't go anywhere near.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.